It's 3 a.m. at the sea. This fish doesn't necessarily do something to piss off this octopus. However, the fish says, "Ah, I'm hurt. I'm hurt by my fellow ocean wanderer. Why? Why do we hurt our own brothers and sisters? Do we truly are hateful creatures? Or do we just hate our own weaknesses and we see that weakness in our people as well?" Life at the sea can be tough. Sometimes people can be unforgiving. Might be because their energy has already been used to deal with other stuff. Who am I to judge? However, how do you feel about this? Or doesn't care? I mean, we're just minding our own business. However, this is but a social media, the inglorious land of strife. You are off to plant the seeds of controversy. A. Some of you might support the fish, because, duh, they do absolutely nothing against the octopus. They deserve no aggression from someone who can't keep their own dumb. B. Some of you might support the octopus. Being an octopus, a creature that is known for high intelligence, imagine being the only smart creature having to roam around dumbasses that have a memory capacity of 6 seconds. Anyone would snap. Remember Squidward? He literally lives between two of the most annoying creatures of the entire ocean. Sure, he will get grumpy all day, like, all his life. Damn. A or B, anyone could argue, but nobody can give a solution that is absolute. No one could bring an evidence, a concrete evidence, or receive the answer from God.
It's B, yo.
Talking by logic and or heart, as Einstein, it omega 3, no one can ever make a perfect line between black and white. In the end, your choices will remain in the moral gray area. Knowing this, I lose reasons to argue. It loses meaning. I realize the driving force of me fighting for my chosen opinion is not out of moral for the octopus or the fish, but my own ego. I only like to see my opinion wins, which will never truly happen. So, I sat up, minding my own business, behave, be mature. That's not right. It's no fun. No fun is not right. As if you will make things better that way. This is the land of social after all. You are off to steer chaos. However, what options are left? Analyzing A, there must be some undeniable norm that can tackle B's cynicism. Analyzing B, there's supposed to be some relatable things that are irrefutable. How about yesing both of them? A new choice. C, both are true. Unfortunately, they both exist by a cause and for a reason. We need to accept them and learn to coexist. Bah. How lame. I don't want peace. I want victory. I want to see my enemies defeated. I mean, destroyed. Wait, I want to see them suffer. That's what I need. However, how? How can I turn this stalemate into a mastery? My analysis is not yet strong enough to... If none of the party can bring me total domination, I just have to build my own party. I present to you, D. All of you were wrong. Both answers are wrong. Everyone is guilty for existing. Their existence is what brings discord into here. If you weren't exist in the first place, there won't be a problem. I know how to attain my victory. Should have done this since the 1950s. Maybe you are not that cynical. You are not an egoist. Maybe you do want justice to win. You believe that your choice is the truth, the right thing. However, you are running out of time. the opportunity is going to slip, so you have to choose. Pick a side, even though you are not sure yet. Unfortunately, that might be the case. C might be true after all. You are all correct in its own way. You do what you think is right. You all are good. I hope that's good enough. Subscribe.